Not yet, Colonel. Wait till you get a clear shot. You damn fool, I told you, wait! That's not some clay animal the fairground is shooting at.
I'm sorry, old man. I thought I could make it.
Wangaza wajua, it's a pipi wabwana.
What's the matter, Merchant?
It'll be dark in an hour. I can't leave it to suffer all night. Well, let's go after it. You better go back to camp.
Wouldn't you like me to come with you?
You're dead right I would. A woundy cat's one of the most dangerous animals there is. Might teach you something.
Marchant. I realize that while I'm on this safari, I'm your responsibility. But I think I'd like to go, whatever the danger.
I'm sorry, Colonel Hammond. I had no right to shout at you like that. But the animals in this country are part of my life. And I hate to see them abused in any way. You go back to camp. Your daughter should be arriving tonight. You must be there to meet her.
All right, David, if you think it's best. Good luck. See you later.
Right. Come on, let's hurry. Release the antelope.
Look here.
We can't be far behind.
Look up.
What is it?
It is the sign of the sacred white rhino that guards the entry to the lands of the Kulnaka. Wait, Bwana. You would enter their lands?
Well, we haven't come this far to be turned back by a primitive tree carving.
But here, the devils of darkness are all about us.
The devils of what?
The spirits of the past that protect their holy shrine from the desecration of unworthy eyes.
They won't come with us?
They dare not.
And you? Do you believe in this? Then wait here.
Thank you.
Malinga, peace to you.
You are on the hallowed hunting grounds of the Kulnaka. No hunter is allowed here.
I only came to end the suffering of this wounded beast.
Your presence has disturbed the spirit of the white rhinoceros.
He who watches over you would understand. Can you not also forgive me?
That is for our leaders to decide. But it is written that whenever the pale ones return, they must die. Come.
You who have entered the sacred land and disturbed the tormented spirits must die.
Is there no defense I can offer?
None. For your fate was sealed in the dark days of the past, when this area was the domain of the rare white rhinoceros. In that time, tribes of the primitive white races came from the far north, and having no fear of or respect for our religion, entered this area and senselessly slaughtered the sacred beasts. Instead of falling upon them and killing them for this sacrilege, we of the Kulnaka accepted their false idol and entered into a hideous pact with them. In this, we displeased our gods, who placed us in spiritual bondage until the white rhinoceros itself reappears. Or until the false idol shatters. Until such time as either of these signs from the gods appears, all who enter the sacred land must die.
Don't be afraid. Let me help you. I was trying to help her. Who are you?
Your clothes are different. You are different. Can you speak our tongue?
Yes.
Where do you come from?
A land far from here.
Why did you come?
I can only believe the fates brought me here.
And they brought you to me. Take him!
Thank you. I'm sorry I had to hurt you. What is your name?
They call me Saria.
Mine is David.
You came to help us?
If I can. Tell me something about this place, Saria.
It is our prison. This room will be yours.
So when we met out there in the jungle, you were trying to escape?
Yes. But there is no escape from Kari. We are her slaves.
Slaves? How long has it been like this?
For as long as I can remember.
Why not rebel?
You make it sound so easy. She's not only protected by the Tongueless Ones, but beyond, by the devils.
Devils?
Yes, they are everywhere.
Who are they?
They are our guardians. They shield us from the cruel world outside. And in return, on each new moon, one of us must wed them. The bride is never seen again. It is our fate.
No one must accept it a fate, Saria. Are there no men here to help you?
But you said you had come to help us.
But your men, where are they?
They are no longer men.
Take her.
I did not save you for others, strange one. You're mine, and mine alone. Think on this.
Now there are two mouths to eat before we get ours. Oh! We are hungry also.
If you choose to have your food upon the ground, then let it be so. You may eat.
I will tear the heart from her.
Now is not the time.
Look at her. She eats upon a throne whilst we grovel in the dust. We are not beasts of the field. We are women equal to her.
You are wrong. You are my slaves. Let her go. Let the dancing continue.
Permit me, my queen, to speak.
Speak, slave.
The women are sad. And when the heart is heavy, the feet are not light. Let there be no more dancing.
You heard my command. Dance!
Mm-hmm.
refuse me?
What else can you expect? Your heartless cruelty is sickening.
You'd have me otherwise.
What makes you so cruel?
Cruelty has made me cruel. I was once their slave. Before the devils came, we dark ones were in bondage to the fair ones. You would have pitied me then, a meek, cringing creature. You would have pitied me, but you would not have wanted me.
I don't want you now.
Why not? Must a woman always be subservient to a man to be wanted?
No.
Do you suggest we should be equals?
Yes.
Then I offer you equality. Share my throne and my kingdom with me.
If you abandon the harshness of your regime, yes, I could accept your
you
offer.
See? Already you want to impose your will. You want to dominate me. I'd be a fool to let any man do that again. But you will want me. And on my terms.
Never.
I am queen here. I will not be denied.
You will never rule me.
Then, like the others, you will become my slave. Take him. Tomorrow you will learn what happens to those who try to master me.
Poor Syria. She's too young to have suffered so.
Then let this be your lesson. Many more of us will have to suffer if you persist in this senseless search for freedom. There is no escape.
Lie still, little one.
Is he safe? Have they hurt him?
Who?
The stranger. The one that came to help us.
Don't expect too much from him. Kari has taken him for her own. He has not resisted.
I don't believe you. He wouldn't betray me.
Do you still refuse me? Let us see what a visit in there will do to weaken your resolve.
And your stupid tongue is silenced forever, the happier I shall be. Work! He hates you. Why?
The man he used to hate died last week. He needs someone new. They all hate. It keeps them alive.
You do not hate.
I am too old, even for hatred.
Quiet! Work!
The ceremony of selection begin. Won't help. Bride will be...
not look upon us with such disgust. We too were once a civilized people. It's hard to believe now. But it was so when we first came to the sacred land of the white rhinoceros.
Even where I have come from, I have heard much of this legend. Tell me, how did it begin?
Our forefathers brought us here. We were not superstitious like the others. And we hunted the white rhinoceros till it finally became extinct. Then we erected a false image to make others believe that it still lived. In this way, we offended the gods, and the legend was born. They sent us a tribe of dark people who came here looking for sanctuary for our protection. They were less intelligent people, and instead of nurturing them, we made them our slaves. This easing of our daily burden made us soft and thoughtless to the well-being of others. And one day, a young slave girl escaped. She went to the most barbaric of the neighboring tribes, those who call themselves the Devils of Darkness. She betrayed our secret. No longer fearing the spirit of the white rhinoceros, the devils fell upon us. Our women were enslaved. The men put in here, and that young slave girl was made our queen.
A more evil woman could not have been chosen.
Huh? How could she know better? The evil within her was put there by us. Our own selfishness and greed had grown tenfold on fertile soil and had turned against us. But these false doctrines that we have created will be washed from the minds of men.
No, you're wrong. The legend will not die.
Then we can only pray for the forgiveness of the gods. For the legend is that we must all remain in spiritual bondage till the white rhino itself reappears and the false idol rent asunder.
Take Amiak away from us now.
We must rebel.
Let us rise up.
Without Amiak, we are lost.
She is our leader.
No. You must take no action. You are not ready yet. We must only choose a new leader. Let Surya lead you after I am gone.
Any form of resistance means death. Then you won't join us? We must all be brides someday. It is our destiny. Only the gods can change one's destiny. And you are not gods.
We must go to the stranger. He will help us. How can he help you, little one? He's imprisoned with the other men.
But he's not like other men.
To you, he isn't.
He's not like other men in that Kali desires him. If he were to become her man, he could use his position in helping us destroy her.
And could you agree to allowing this stranger to become Kali's man?
I must agree, for all our sakes.
Are you not afraid? Yes, little one, I am afraid.
Refused her, but if you were to change your mind.
Do you know what you're asking?
Yes. Yes, I know, but you must help us. Please, promise me that you will.
How can I refuse you? When this is over, we'll be together.
No. When this is over, you will leave us.
I will never leave you.
The legend foretells that when the stranger comes to free us and his task is done, he will return to his own land alone.
I won't leave you.
Is she your special woman?
Yes.
I had forgotten about such things.
On my terms, completely?
Yes.
You will run my household?
Yes.
Look after my clothing?
Yes.
Mix my perfumes?
Yes.
In fact, you will do everything that I ask?
Yes.
Fetch me my robe. Why do you hesitate?
It will take me a little time to...
You must learn that each command must be obeyed at once. Body hungers. Bring food and drink to my chambers.
Promise. There is no promise.
He has fulfilled your desires only because I made him promise that he would.
Is this true?
She is confused. She doesn't know what she's saying.
Is it true?
He did it for all our sakes.
Let him see daylight again. Never. 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 Bring her.
again. Never! Never!
Devils, I hear. They've come for a bride.
Why did you stop him? I couldn't bear to see him humiliated anymore. And yet to save him, you've condemned yourself. And us. While he and the other men still live, you must not lose hope.
The men? What use are they? Better they were dead. They've become beasts.
You must think of the men not as enemies, but as friends. Then together you will conquer. It is the only way.
No, no, he can stand it no more. He's right. Pain won't last long. Come, let us try again.
Thank you. free?
Yes.
The gods were kind. My one prayer was to die free. Am I free? I am free. I am. There is work to be done.
harm us.
We won't need them anymore.
You don't think they'll come back?
No. The legend... it's partly fulfilled.
I don't care what the legend says. I won't leave you.
My world is not yours. This much I understand.
How can you know that?
You came to help us and your task is finished. And now you must leave.
Maria! Are we never to be together?
Not until the gods who watch over us wish it to be so.
I love you.
And my love for you will last forever.
We are free. Our souls are no longer in bondage. We are free! Our gods chose you to free us from this burden that has tormented us through the ages. The Kulnaka will be eternally grateful. The temple of the false idol must be destroyed! Adagio!
What happened, Buana? I thought you were in danger.
Chaka, how long was I in there?
Only for one moment.
One moment?
What happened?
I'm not sure. There was a sheet of lightning.
What has happened to them?
They are not as fierce a tribe as you would have me believe, Chaka.
I think it's safer we get back to camp.
Pity David didn't get that leopard, my dear. The skin would have made a nice present for our daughter.
John, did you notice anything strange about Mr. Marchant when he came back?
Can't say I did. Why?
He had a sort of faraway look in his eye. Almost as if he...
Excuse me, Buana. The others are coming.
Splendid. Now tell Mr. Marchant. What if they've got some English newspapers?
The others have come, Buana.
Thank you. I'll be out in a moment. John!
David!
Hello, good journey.
Fine, David, fine. Hope I haven't missed any excitement here.
No, not really.
Well, come on then, come and meet the new people. Mr. and Mrs. Perkins from London.
Mrs. Perkins, Mr. Perkins.
And Mr. Peter O'Donnell.
Mr. O'Donnell, please make yourselves at home. My head boy will show you the sleeping arrangements.
There's another one here somewhere. Ah, there she is.
How's everything at home?
Oh, Sarah, I'd like you to meet Mr. David Marchant.